So far, we have used Le Chatelier principle to understand towards what direction either reactants or products will the reaction evolves when we change a parameter. We have seen that when we change concentrations, say the concentration of reactants, if we increase the concentration of reactants, this will displace the reaction towards the right. For pressure, it depends on the molecularity, it depends on how many molecules of reactants and products you have in gas form, but typically you can see in what case you have more reaction, more molecules, and in any case that was the effect of pressure. But what I want to make sure here is that in both cases, changing concentrations or changing pressure, the equilibrium constant was constant, was kept constant. And that was the main motivation to reach a new equilibrium, because the equilibrium constant was to be kept constant. What happens when we change the temperature? Well, this changes a lot the outcome, because changing temperature, you can change the equilibrium constant. So it's not only a restoration of a new situation of equilibrium, it's a different equilibrium, because if you change the temperature, you will change the equilibrium constant. But we can still apply a pseudo Le Chatelier principle, which the mechanism is different because the equilibrium constant is different now. But you can think in terms of if the reaction is exothermic or endothermic. So when you have an exothermic reaction, you can think heat being a product. That will be an exothermic reaction. When you have an endothermic reaction, you need heat for the reaction to take place, so therefore heat is a reactant, and that will be for endothermic. So in that case, depending on if the reaction is exothermic or endothermic, this new applied Le Chatelier principle will be different. So how does this work? If you have an exothermic reaction, if you apply heat, notice that you are adding products. So for an exothermic reaction, if you increase the temperature, the reaction is going to be towards reactants. If you increase the temp because you are supposed to consume If you increase the temperature, you're adding heat, therefore the reaction will try to consume that heat that is a product. However, if for an endothermic reaction, if you increase the temperature, the reaction will evolve towards products, because heat appears like a reactant, and the new situation of equilibrium will try to consume this perturbation will try to consume heat, and that will take place if the reaction is shifted towards products. Okay, so this is what this is saying. A temperature will rise. A temperature rise will increase K for a system with a positive, that is for endothermic. Okay. And the temperature rise will decrease K, that is, and again, increase K means that it'll move towards products, right? And it will decrease K if means that it will move toward reactants, and that will only be when you have an exothermic reaction, all right? And you can do the same for a temperature decrease. Hopefully that is clear. Let's see if we can understand this with an exercise. In this case, it's asking for, if we increase the temperature for these three reactions, how does an increase of temperature will affect the concentration of the underlying substances? All right, so this is endothermic. That means that, think of heat as if it were a product. If we increase the temperature, we're increasing the temperature for all these three cases, so if we increase the temperature and heat is a product, the reaction will try to counteract that heat being given, therefore it will move towards reactants, the concentration of the underlying substance will decrease. In this case, case B, this is positive, therefore it's endothermic, that means you have heat as a reactant. If you increase the temperature, the reaction will try to diminish that effect by consuming the heat, therefore it'll move to the right, you will be creating some CO2, so the concentration of CO2 will increase, and in here was calcium hydroxide decreasing. Finally, If you have, notice that in this case it's not about keeping the equilibrium constant constant. We are not paying attention to if it's a solid or it's a liquid. Do not worry about that. But in this case, this again, it's endothermic, so you'll have a Q in here. If you increase the temperature, the reaction will move to the right, the concentration of SO2 will decrease. Okay? In all these cases, we're talking about the equilibrium constant increasing or decreasing. Therefore, in the situation of equilibrium, what is the new concentration? Careful, because some videos before we have said that in order for a reaction to happen, you need to provide temperature. So what you see sometimes is that, well, how do you build a fire? You build a fire by adding heat. Even though the very combustion is a very exothermic reaction, it seems counterintuitive to what we have said so far. A combustion reaction is exothermic, and yet you can make it happen by adding heat. How does that contradict what we have said? No, this is a different effect. This is a kinetic effect. This is, well, you could be staring at that wood for a while, but you need to provide some heat for the wood to start burning. That's a kinetic effect. You want the reaction to happen fast. That does not mean that the equilibrium constant is larger or smaller. Definitely it will be smaller, but you will barely notice that effect. What interests you is to get the reaction going. Okay, so careful, do not confuse those two phenomena. Finally, let's see if we can combine all the effects of pressure, concentration, of temperature. Let's see. So it says, given the following reaction, could you increase the concentration of products? And because this is an exothermic reaction, you're gonna put heat as products. So if we increase the volume, what happens if we increase the volume? Notice that if we increase the volume, the pressure will decrease. What happens if we decrease the pressure? The system will try to increase the pressure. If we increase the volume, the pressure will decrease. It will move towards the right. Why? Because the system will try to increase the pressure, and there are four molecules as reactants. Sorry, it will move, sorry, to the left. It will move to the left. So therefore, we want to decrease the volume so that the pressure increases. If we want to increase the concentration of ammonia, we want to decrease the volume so that the pressure increases. So let's just choose the options that involve decreasing the volume. It has to be this one, or this one. Now, do we need to add or remove ammonia? If we add ammonia, it will shift towards the right, and we will obtain our desired concentration of increase of concentration of ammonia. So this already confirms that this is the only option, and hopefully it should make sense with the temperature. If we decrease the temperature, that means the reaction will try to compensate that decrease of temperature by creating heat. It will shift towards the right. So yes, this will be the combination of volume, pressure, adding ammonia, and temperature that will increase the concentration of ammonia or increase the concentration of products.